In this video for our Yamaha ZG01 quick setup series, we'll take a look at how to use the audio drivers from the ZG01 game streaming audio mixer to record or stream audio from your mic, voice chat apps, and gaming console. In previous videos, we saw how the ZG01 creates two separate audio drivers for recording: ZG Voice and ZG Game on Mac, and ZG Voice and ZG Streaming on Windows. Using the ZG Voice driver alone will only record the ZG's microphone audio and effects, with those being controlled from the ZG01's fader and buttons. For combining our voice, PC or mobile chat app audio, and gaming audio though, we'll need our recording or streaming applications to be assigned to the ZG Game or Streaming driver. From the ZG controller's main screen, open the sixth tab on the left to see the streaming output mixer. It's important to note that the streaming output mixer only provides control for audio output through the Mac ZG Game or Windows ZG Streaming drivers. This page will let you set up and route audio for streaming or recording. The streaming output mixer combines three inputs: mic, voice, and game. Mic audio comes from either the XLR phone combo jack on the back of the ZG unit or the headset mic input on the front, plus any mic effects. Voice captures stereo audio of any applications using the ZG voice driver. The aux jack also sends audio to the voice input and can be used to connect your smart device for voice chat apps, party chat through your console's controller, or for recording mobile device gameplay audio. Game captures up to 7.1 channel audio from any applications, games, or video players using the ZG Game or Streaming drivers, as well as any audio from the ZG's HDMI inputs. Each input has meters and a level control slider, so you can adjust the amount of audio from each source going into your recording or streaming application. The voice and game inputs can also include the game effects from the 1, 2, or 3 buttons on the ZG, allowing you to choose when your viewers hear any customized voice chat or gameplay effects you created. A mute button is also available for each input, so you can temporarily mute any source, like for breaks during gameplay. The ZG01 also has an HDMI mute button next to the HDMI selector. This can be another easy way to quickly mute console game audio. Once you have audio coming through your inputs, you can use the monitor button in the output section to listen to the mix your viewers will hear and make adjustments. Then, when you want to get back to your own personal gameplay mix, turn off the monitor button. The ZG01 can then output the combined audio in stereo in two ways: through the USB-C connection to your computer's streaming or recording software, or through the HDMI out jack to your capture card and/or monitor. When enabling the USB-C port, a pop-up reminder about not infringing on copyrights will appear. It's important to note that, similar to most capture cards, when an HDMI signal carrying HDCP protection is input to the ZG, audio will stop being passed out of the ZG's USB-C port. So if you'd like to record gameplay, ensure that the HDCP settings for your device are disabled so the audio can pass through. If your device's HDCP is enabled, you will still be able to hear audio through the ZG unit, but any streaming or recording applications will no longer receive any audio from the ZG. With your streaming or recording software input set to ZG Game or Streaming, you're ready to start showing your viewers what you've got.